I want to share you my faith during my illness. This was written by Father Roman Felix and translated by Adam Onko Vidato. I was introduced to Mrs. Annie Lee through email. She was born on January 1st, 1941, 75 years at the time this was written. Mrs. Annie currently lives in Canada. I knew her through Mrs. Johanna, one of the participants of Pina Langkit Kitab Suci, roughly translated to further learning of the Bible. My teacher and Mr. August in the community of Emmaus Journey, Sorbonne. I was very surprised when I found out that Mrs. Annie had helped in the development of a prayer house and the Grotto of Mary in the Solia parish of Odelia, Tangerang, in the suburb of Archdiocese of Jakarta. I thought to myself, she must lead a very faithful spiritual life. I find that to be true from the fact that she had offered the development of the Grotto of Mary in memory of Eka, her only son, who had called to his side for the Lord God Almighty. Eka was suffering from leukemia before he passed away. Before he was called by the Father, he had oftentimes felt the presence of God. God gave him a message, "You will be healed." The real meaning of that message was understood by myself after Eka had passed away. It was totally healing. Totally healing is the eternal happiness. The eternal happiness that he received by following the teaching of the gospel. God showed him the way to eternal happiness through a dream where God gave him four books. Mrs. Annie interpreted those books are the Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. The center of the gospel is living your life full of love. Love is the new commandment as a gift from Jesus Christ. As he had said on his way to Mount Calvary, "I give you a new commandment. Love one another. You must love one another just as I have loved you," with the written John 13, verse 34. This commandment of Jesus Christ is renewed because love comes alive when it is done wholeheartedly according to his example. Eka kept on telling the people who prayed for him to follow God's commandment to love one another shortly before he passed away. "Please help Kevin." Kevin is Eka's childhood friend. Friday morning, after saying that, Eka told Daisy, his wife, "I'm going home tonight." He passed away that day, Friday, June the 28th, at 1945. At 30 years old, the same age as Jesus Christ when he was crucified. He died at the exact time as he had told Mrs. Annie on Tuesday, June the 25th. "Mom, I'm going home on Friday." The next Saturday, I think Norton, Eka's close friend, went looking for Kevin, and true enough, he found Kevin in a troubled state. Mrs. Annie Lim's heart must have crumbled in pieces with Eka's departure, especially from the fact that Eka is her only son. However, her spiritual director, with his Marco Testa, kept empowering her in accepting Eka's death. "Annie, you should be happy that Eka knows that he is going to the Father." Eka must have had a very pure heart, such that he was allowed to meet God before he passed away. And now he must have gone to his side in his kingdom. "Blessed are the pure in heart, they shall see God," Matthew 5, verse 8. Mrs. Annie Close's revelation said to God had granted her the vision of a peaceful place for Eka when he was sick. The vision was of Eka in a white robe, lying on the green grass surrounded by lilies. The grass and lilies are like what were described in Psalm 23, especially chapter 2. In grassy meadows, he lets me lie. By tranquil stream, he leads me. What made Mrs. Annie happy after Eka's death was the fact that there are many of his friends who changed their way of life and became close to God. Eka was like a root that sacrificed itself by boring deep into the ground so that the seed can grow into a plant on the surface, enjoying the warmth of the sun. A real example of this was Kevin, who was very touched with the warmth of God's love to Eka. I was really touched by Eka's love, who still remembered me in his last few seconds on earth. Thanks to her closeness to God, Mrs. Annie was able to treat Eka's death as a beautiful spiritual experience. Mother Mary had Jesus Christ for only 33 years and had to give him up to save mankind. I also have Eka for 33 years, and I have sacrificed my only son so that more people who will become close to him. The deep faith really touched my heart. A lot of people grew apart from God when their only child had been called by him. But Mrs. Annie grew even closer to God and became the channel of his blessing. The moral message that we can reflect on Mrs. Annie's testimony about Eka is etched on this wise word. Close your eyes, then consider everything in this world as empty and temporary. Consider everything never existed in the first place, and then think of God and his commandment, so you will feel his life. You will feel how peaceful it is being held on his shelter. Guard me as the pupil of an eye. Shelter me in the shadow of your wings. It is on Psalm 17, verse 8. God bless. And here you could see Eka's during his teenager years.
Come.
And there is the grotto of Mother Mary, which has been dedicated to Edgar and was blessed on June the 19th of this year by the Archdiocese of Archbishop from Jakarta. This is when it was in construction.